I'm getting a ridiculous amount of remote deals coming in, and every now and again I'm getting these deals where, like, you know, I have so much going on and so much to get through that I just throw out an offer and people take it, and then I go and I look, once I get the coins and I look at the offer I made, and it's like, I'm gonna do very well on these. That was a good offer for me to make. So this is one of the better offers I've made, and I'm gonna probably keep some of these for myself. And what I'm debating to do I want to send every single one of these in to get graded? Because I could, and if I did, there's a lot of money to be made here, but then my cash gets tied up for maybe upwards of 5 months. However, it's not a lot of cash in this case. It's only $230. These are uncirculated 1936, 37, 38, 39 silver marks from Nazi Germany. So it's Hindenburg on the obverse, and the reverse is the Iron Eagle. And each of these coins, if I sent them in, they'd be graded. Low end, these are about uncirculated. High end, these are MS60. So these are $30 to $100 a coin, and I paid $230 for all of them. So I don't know what I'm going to do yet. I'm definitely going to keep some of them for myself. I just made a TikTok about this. That's the key to getting rich in this business, is as you do these deals, you part out something here, something there, and you stick it away. It's not going into my pocket. It's the store's inventory. But by doing that, I am building up quite a backlog of very expensive, very nice inventory. So as for what I'm going to do with these, I'm not 100% sure yet. I don't know. Unfortunately, I don't know how to grade these. I'm using the grading I know about Morgan silver dollars, like with the chest feathers and where the coin might have wear, and I'm applying that to this. But they look to be uncirculated to me. I can see all the details in the feathers of the Iron Eagle. I can see all the lines in Hindenburg's face. November criminal. That's a historical joke that I bet two people get tops. Sending these off to get graded is, it's gonna take too long. It's gonna be too much of a headache, and I've been so frustrated with grading lately. So I put these up on Instagram, $50 each, and somebody just offered me one of each year, 36, 37, 38, 39 for 140, and I am taking that. And again, I have 230 into all of this. So 140 out, 230 still left, so $90, and this is what I'm sitting on, and I pocketed one for myself. So yeah, I'm gonna do very well on this. All right, this is a 14 carat, like Jesus pendant, crucifix. It's stamp 14 on the back. Got my fishing magnet. Nothing, that's a good sign. I'm gonna rub here, I'm gonna rub here, I'm gonna rub here. Uh-uh, no, that disappeared. So this did not pass my acid test. Huh? This did not pass my acid test.
Why?
I mean, I would assume it's not real gold. So what I do is I make a mark on this block here, mm-hmm. and then I put 14 karat nitric acid on it.
Uh-huh. Sounds fake.
Yeah, it's not real.
It's not real.
It's not real.
Wow.
So that turned out to be fake, and I have to do that from time to time, is break it to people that the heirloom that they've had for a long time, somebody got ripped off decades ago.
Oh, Deloitte. Finally sold this. The second of my three Nazi daggers has gone out, has left the building. I got $800 on it, paid $666 a blade if you want to divide 2,000 divided by three. So I guess I am making some money. I could have done without sitting on this for 5 months, but still. And then I am giving them a copy of my novel, Wolf in the, oh, somebody's walking in here. Figured a Nazi hunter novel goes with a Nazi dagger. Hello.
I did not get this deal on camera because I'm having a case of the Mondays. I had a local guy I've done a lot of business with come in here and sell me this football stuff. He said I have some sports stuff, and I was like, but then I was reminded of the fire trucks and how well we did on those, and I thought, eh. So they are Green Bay Packers. They're like Christmas decorations for Packers fans, and yeah, these go for like $100 each online. This is as not Evan as it gets. Like, this is so outside of my personal wheelhouse of like things that I would be interested in. I don't like sports. This is such Goyim shit to me. Like, this just screams Goyim shit with a capital G through and through. But $35 a box is what I ended up paying. I offered him $200 for all seven. He wanted four. I was like, no, because that's probably what I'm gonna get on him. We met at 250. He tried to get me up to three. Kind of wish I would have filmed it. I was being a pretty firm negotiator. So, I mean, the individual seems to like me personally. I've been doing a lot of business with him since I was at the old shop, and he came specifically to me with these. I wanted to make a deal with him, but like, I don't want to like pay more money. And like, in the past when I've done deals with this guy, I've let him talk me up, and I've like kind of learned that, like, you know, I have to be firm. So ended up with these, $35 a box. We're gonna throw them up on eBay and see how they do. And I would make a TikTok about it, but I am suspended from making TikToks for the rest of the day because there's some fucking jackass going around town here robbing shops. And I made a video, a TikTok about it, and I put out a $250 reward for anybody who can lead to the guy's arrest. And I got the video taken down for illegal goods and services. Me trying to catch a thief is illegal goods and services, so. Awesome TikTok, now I can't post for the rest of the day. I was just talking about this with this guy that came in here. It's like, yeah, it's great to be able to run a business on social media and do what I'm doing and like nobody else is doing it. But there's also a hidden dark side to it. And that dark side is I'm subject to whatever TikTok deems, you know, their moral clauses. So like randomly I'll put out a video that it didn't even occur to me might piss them off. And you know, this is a great case in point example. It didn't even occur to me that me trying to catch a thief is me doing something illegal. The joys of Monday. Holy shit.
Yes.
Ooh.
It was an original.
That's what's up. I'm going to count them up. 175 each?
150.
Okay. All right, so let's see how many we got here. We got one or two. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 3, 4, 3, 5. Yep, 36. Okay. You said 250 on this bag?
Yes. Okay.
One. 2, 3, 4. Okay, 151. $316.50. All right, 3, 16, 50. I'm giving you a dollar coin. Because I got too many of them. All right, so I paid $216.50 in this bag, $90 in this bag. I'll probably get $5 to $10 a pin here. So I'll probably make about $200-$300 on this. I do really well in the Soviet stuff, and that guy is from Russia. His family has, they immigrated here and they have a lot of original stuff that he's been liquidating to me. Make some good profit here. This bag, some of this stuff is junk. Some of the stuff is kind of nicer. I mean, there's definitely some research to be done, but all in all, I mean, this could be a $300 or $400 profit, what I just did. But this is not gonna sell quickly. I might sit on this stuff for like 2 or 3 years.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
Yeah, sure we got top quality stuff today. Always a good sign when it starts in a trash bag. The best things start in trash bags. I began in a trash bag.
I was about to take that joke. Did I just
call my mom's uterus a trash bag?
Don't do that.
Let's see what we got. Okay, so again, Danny, I can't do big heavy stuff. Like I straight up don't want it. This is firewood and I can't do appliances.
Oh, okay.
I don't want hardware, so I guess we're gonna say no to this stuff. Okay, Christmas 1975.
There's an extra copy, I think, on the table.
It's like an old used bag. Kind of not my forte. Peace on earth, dove.
Keep on digging, Evan. Keep on digging.
Oh, Evan's digging.
Keep on digging, Evan. Keep on digging, sir.
PCS. What is this? You don't know what it is?
Milestone.
I mean, I know that, but is it like some kind of an antique or something? This is broken.
Yeah, exactly.
Sure.
This is broken. It's just a bunch of Christmas ornaments. Oh. I give you $5.
Can you go 10?
No, I don't want to go 10. I don't want to give you anything, but you came out here.
Yeah, 5 is fine.
5 is all right? All right, we got a deal for $5.
Oh, you can't use anything else in that bag.
I can't use anything else in that bag.
The briefcase is nice.
I don't think that briefcase is nice. That looks like something I could pull out of the Goodwill for a dollar. So the Tombstone people next door moved out or died or whatever. And now there's a new studio, like an art studio going in here. They're doing construction today. And today was the day that I was going to film. And every time I whip out my camera to record something, every time I sit down and make a TikTok, it sounds like somebody shitting through the walls. So when I worked at the old shop, there was a store next to us that folded and then like a hem shop went in. And they renovated everything, and it honestly took them like 3 months to renovate. And it was just like blasting, pounding, sawing, like floors being put in for like 3 months. Like I hadn't created Pond Man at that point, but thank God I hadn't, because I fucking wouldn't have been able to film. It was so loud in there. So I'm really, really hoping this only goes on for just a day, because it's, yeah. I'm like, I've only been here for an hour, and I'm like already at the limit of my patience. And of course, like I said, right when they're doing it, I'm like, oh, I'm gonna make a thing about this and film it. And I sit down and hit record and it stops. Cool, we got some more currency. This is military currency from the British Armed Forces. So this is like when a military takes over. So like, you know, when the US took over Japan after World War II, they issue currency for the soldiers. Usually it's for armed forces only. So like, this is one from Japan, from the occupation. Costs 20 bucks for the lot.
20 bucks?
Yeah. And this is China? This is China? I get you 10 bucks for the pair.
Cool.
That sounds all right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Well, keep bringing me stuff. I like it.
This is what all it is. I was excited about this when I walked in. I never have seen this stuff before. So, you know, I thought, oh, military currency. You know, these go for like 10 bucks a note, but these are more modern. I don't even see a date on these. So yeah, I'll probably, like I said, I got 10 bucks or 20 bucks into this deal. I'll get 30 to maybe 35 out. The good news is I bet I'll be able to sell it within probably like 20 minutes. I bet I'll take a picture on Instagram and this will go quick because it's more unique. It's just not expensive. But then he whips out, he's got a North Korean note, which is random. It's in pretty good shape. I'd get 20 bucks on this. This one, I have to look up. I think it's from China. I honestly don't know for sure. I'm a little weaker on currency. So I'm having a day, but when am I not? So I gotta look this one up, but I don't think this one's terribly expensive. And then these, I was being straight with them. I got $3 into this. I'll get five out. This is, I'm gonna just put this in my currency folder I have right here, which is growing. And like, then I just do like big lots. And there's some better pieces in here, but for the most part, not expensive stuff in this folder. And then this one I'll put up on Instagram for 20 bucks. 25, I'm a pirate.
What's going on, you guys? We're Between the Pond. I'm Evan. This is my gold and silver business. How has the week been? Shit, I've been busy. This has been great. I have had so much walk-in traffic this week. Yesterday, we did 5 gold buys, just person after person. They're saying, we saw your review on Google. You're clearly the best in town. But no, it's been going really well. I've been really busy. My other guy quit his part-time job. He's full-time here. So I got 2 employees that are working here full-time, and it's allowing me to put more time and effort into social media. I kind of burned myself out last week. I don't know if you guys noticed. I did like 5 TikToks a day, but it's all gravy. It's all good. Every day I'm looking, you know, I'm doing the accounting and I'm looking to see what we're making every day. We're having like $2,000-$3,000 days in profits every day this week. This has just been incredible. So hopefully this keeps up. My remote deal program is going really great. I now have an antiques dealer in another state who's sending me stuff exclusively instead of going to their local gold and silver shops. It's going well. Things are really, really, really looking up. We're just coming up here on the 1-year anniversary of opening up the shop. April 1st is the date, and yeah, it's incredible. What a year it has been. And it is, I say this all the time, but it is thanks to you guys. I would have been dead in the water without my social media audience. Fucking nobody walked in here in April. I think I had 2 people walk into my store my first month of business. I had 5 my second month. And then June, it started picking up a little bit. And now I'm just roaring. People are coming to me first. My phone's ringing all the time. So all good things. What else is going on? You guys, we are hunting for a criminal. I am mobilizing my social media audience to catch this fat bastard. There is a guy, I have nicknamed him the Blubbery Bullion Bandit. He is 6'3", in his mid-40s, approximately 400 pounds, driving the vehicle seen in the photos. I've been talking about him on TikTok. I am offering a $500 reward of my own money to catch this jackass. This guy, there's an elderly Jewish guy I'm friendly with, I do a lot of business with. He's a jewelry store owner. This guy went into a shop about a month ago, asked to try on a gold bracelet, and socked him in the face and ran out. And then last week, another guy I do a lot of business with, this guy went into his store and swiped an ounce of gold. And I keep hearing the description, he ran out. Can't picture him running. It's like, what, did he fucking juggernaut through the wall or something? So this guy's all masked up. I unfortunately don't have very good footage of him. What you see on social media is all I have. But a local police detective in a suburb south of here reached out to me. Apparently he's a suspect in some cases down in that city. And so I'm just forwarding all the information I get to this detective. I'm really, really hoping we can catch him. And you guys, there's 200,000 of us now. This guy is 6'3", 400 something pounds. I bet there's 20 people in the pool of the metro that he could be. There's only like 3 million people that live here. I so wanna catch this guy, and I wanna send a message that if you're gonna come to the Twin Cities and you're gonna commit crimes against bullion shops or gold shops like mine, I'm gonna fucking find you. I'm gonna use my social media to find you as best I can. Any tips, any information, let me know. I'm forwarding it, like I said, to a police detective who's investigating it. I feel confident that if I keep the heat on, we can catch this guy. So we're gonna get into the questions now. I have 7 questions this week, so thank you guys. Question 1, coming in from JPod18. JPod is asking, Pond Man, with your online sales with Discord and eBay, which one do you make more from? I only ask because I know you have to pay eBay fee for use their services. Okay. I get annoyed when a message is discombobulated. This is the era of spell check. I always punctuate and properly spell things when I write a public. Anyway. Appreciate the question. Discord's going great. I'm so glad that we made the Discord when we did. I made it in October when I got suspended from eBay. There's over 2,000 people in the Discord now. If you guys are not in the Discord, go check it out. It's a thriving community. I have a free appraisal service section. I don't do the appraisals, but the community does, and I use it myself. It's pretty good. There's some smart people that are on the Discord. There's some people that are just like straight up hanging out on there quite a lot. I myself don't participate a whole lot on Discord because I'm so busy. I don't have time to go and like chat and talk with people because like I go live on TikTok. That's how I engage with fans. And like I respond to messages and stuff. Overall, Discord is a great service. If you're doing something like me, I can't recommend it enough. Question two, I like this one. Cosmo Wow, do you do edibles and go to the aquarium? I'm sure I have at some point. I can't think of a time offhand. I mean, I've done hallucinogens and gone in public. My favorite thing to do, not my favorite thing, but what I do like to do, I'll take magic mushrooms and I'll go into a forest by myself and I'll just lose my fucking mind for like 3 hours and find myself. That I like to do. As far as like taking edibles and going to the, I don't like going to aquariums. The only aquarium here in Minnesota is the Mall of America, and I don't like the Mall of America. It's a bad place. I'll tell you, I have done edibles and gone to the zoo within the last year. A good time. I also took acid, and the next day I went to the zoo, and I had some flashbacks while I was looking at some of the, oh my God, that was very scary. I'm never gonna look at seals the same way again. Okay, question three. Scooter Ford is asking, why don't I show my customers? I'm not at a point right now where I can afford to blow a deal for content. It's getting close, but it's not quite there yet. You know, when I first started filming this, I thought, oh fuck, I'm gonna fuck up so many deals. This is not gonna be worth it. I thought, well, I was right about that. I thought the people that I used to work for were gonna shit a brick when they saw what I was doing, and they did. What surprised me so much and continues to surprise me, just about nobody talks about the camera. I do all kinds of deals with people. I hit the record button as they sit down. They see me hit the record button. It's not a small camera. It's a big camera with a microphone on it. Nobody ever talks about it. It's just part of the deal. What I think people think is it's a protection thing. They think that I'm like trying to film it just in case they do something. They don't realize I'm throwing the shit on YouTube. But if I turn the camera around, I would probably blow sales, and I just don't want to do that. Whenever I grab my B cam, like sometimes I'll have stuff in front of me and, you know, I'm doing the deal this way. But then I want you guys to see my POV, and I don't want to pick up and, you know, because that'll just screw up the shot with the continuity. So I'll grab my B cam, and as soon as I do, then people look. They think I'm going to take a picture of them, and they're like, whoa, what are you doing? So for right now, I'm just not at a point where I'm comfortable putting people's faces on YouTube because it is going to probably cost me money. But if you come in here and you act a fool, like, you know, the video from about a month ago, then I'll put all the fucking footage on. Then I don't care. But it's only if you piss me off and there's not going to be a deal. Because if we're doing a deal, I'm going to respect your privacy. Question four from Charles Burks. Charles says, hey, I'm not a know-it-all by any means. You always say you don't have time, so why buy all this crap? You should buy more quality, not quantity. It's all gravy. I make money on just about everything I buy. I'm not going to turn away anything. I'm going to just gobble, 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 get bigger, and keep at it. That's how you do this business, is you don't turn anything away. You just, if you don't want it, then you buy it for next to nothing. And then you own it for practically free. I mean, look at the shit that I buy from the con artist. I mean, I'm doing something with his stuff. It's content. I will probably get my money back out of him, and I am profitable in my relationship with him. So, you know, that stuff, it adds up. There's a massive pile of stuff in the back, and it keeps my employees busy. It makes it so that we always have new stuff. There's no way I'm gonna turn away crap unless it is actual dog shit crap that I don't want. Question five. Oh, this is a long one. I'm only gonna do a couple of these because this is too many, and I think I answered part of these in the last one. Omiri Winnicur asks, how are the caster wheel sales going? Still have them? I called an industrial supplier to see if they wanted to clean me out, and they ghosted me and never called me back, so. I'm selling like a few boxes a week. I wish they would all sell because I do want to renovate that basement and make it more efficient and make it like a workspace. And I can't do that until all those fucking wheels are gone. If one of you guys knows an industrial wholesaler and knows somebody who might want to buy all those caster wheels, I'd pay a commission just to get rid of them. I so want to get rid of them. There's probably about 10 grand in caster wheels surplus, and like that's like half off from the retail. I know rhodium and palladium are super expensive. Have you bought and sold any rhodium or palladium items? I would straight up not buy rhodium. It's too expensive. The price fluctuates too much, and there's not much desire for it. I have had, I think, zero people in my career ask me for it. So I would probably just turn it away. And then palladium, I'm gonna be really bullish on. I'll pay like 65 cents on the dollar. Cause nobody wants it. It's too expensive. I don't trust the price on it. I think the price is gonna go down on it. And I just borderline don't want it. I will buy palladium. I don't think I've ever even bought it on my own. And then rhodium I would just stay away from. Final question. Pato Swag says, if you could bring back any coin into reproduction, not US, what coin would it be and why? God damn, I really gotta think about this. Maybe something from ancient Japan. maybe a bullion piece from ancient Japan, and I just started buying some ancient Japanese coins, so maybe they do make one, like maybe they made a restrike of one. But like some of the gold pieces from the Tokugawa era, if the Japanese government did a restrike on some of the old coinage that they used to do as like a limited edition, that would be cool. I would love to buy that. And they may have even done that. I don't know. But I guess, yeah, that'd be my answer. All right, guys, that just about does it for this Between the Pawn. If you guys like this video, be sure you give it a thumbs up. Hit that notification button so you know when new episodes of Pawn Man are coming out. I'm posting every week. If you guys got questions for the next Between the Pawn, post it below. I'll try and answer it on the show. Get my books on Amazon. I just published a sequel to my Nazi Hunter novel, Wolf in the Jungle. Just type in Evan Kale on Amazon. They'll all come up. If you guys want to buy from me, message me on Instagram or Discord. Join my Discord. It's a whole community. Follow me on social media, at Evan Kale, at Pawn Man. Spread the gospel of Pawn Man. By spread the gospel, I mean like tell people to watch it. This YouTube channel is finally starting to take off, and it's been, oh my God, pushing a boulder up a mountain for years. What would really help me, you guys, go on Facebook. Just make a post, say this guy is amazing, check out his videos, because I'm not on Facebook. Even though I look like Mark Zuckerberg, I absolutely hate him. I have Instagram, you gotta have one of the evils. But I don't have Facebook, and I recognize it is an opportunity I'm missing out on. So if you guys can go on there, tell people to watch my videos, helps a ton. All right, guys, I'll see you back here for another episode of Pawn Man. Later.